7 Maths Chapter number 3 Data Handling. Today we are going to learn about use of bar graphs with different purpose. Exercise 3.3 for third question is given to you. Number of children in 6 different classes are given below. Here you can see the table. Represent the data on number line. Here observations are given to you, means number of children are given to you in each class. How many? 5th, 6th, 7th, 8th, 9th, 10th, 10th. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 classes are given to you and the number of children in each classes are given to you. Now you have to represent this data in the bar graph. Simply your graph paper will be of this type. Here straight lines will be given to you. Horizontal and vertical lines will be given to you. So first what you have to do, you have to draw y-axis and x-axis first. That same I have drawn over here in the graph paper. Now after that you can see you are leaving two lines over here. You have to draw a straight line and here y-axis and here you have to draw a x-axis. That same I have drawn over here. Now how to take the scale? Now here you can see the smallest number is 80 and the largest number you can see 135. Now after 80 you are getting the next number as 90. That means the difference between 80 and 90 is 10. So we can take scale as 1 centimeter is equal to 10 children. Means in the bar graph here you can see a square over here and here from here if we count here 0, then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 and here the 10. This way 1 centimeter we will take as 10 children. So here we will write first 0. After that 10 till where we have to go till 140 because 135 we have to cover. So 0, after that 20, 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80. Now here we are not having that much space. So what we will do, that here the lowest number is 80. So we will start from 80 over here. Now whenever we are not taking the equal from 0 to the first scale you are taking, not you are not taking equal to 10, then what we have to take here, we will take 0 to 80. First we will write down over here 80. So as we are starting as 80 means this much gap cannot be given as 80. So what we will do here, we will break our y-axis and put a mark in this sense. This means that from here more space is there, 0 to 80. Now here we will continue having 1 centimeter is equal to 10 children. Now here 80, after 80 90, 100, 110, 120, 130, 140. So in small space now we will be able to draw the graphs. Now let us see. For the fifth, number of children is 135. So here you can see between 130 and 140, here exactly here you will get 135. So till here you have to draw the first bar. Now whatever numbering you are taking over here, there is number of children. So here we will write down number of children. Okay, here you have to write down number of children. Wherever the observations you are marking the scale, that side what it is given, number of children are given. So that you have to write down number of children. Now what you are represent is as a bar graph all the 5th, 6th, 7th, 8th, 9th all the classes. So here on the x-axis you will write down as classes. Now here we have represented first means it is the 5th, and here we have to shade this bar. After that next is 120. Here you can see 120 directly. Here you have to draw the next bar. Here you can see next bar I have drawn of 120. Here it will be 6th. Again shade it. Next is 95. Here you can see after between 90 and 100 we are getting 95. So here we will get 95. So here straight line over here we have to draw a bar. This is for 7th. Then for 100. For 100 here you can see here we have to draw for 100. On the graph paper you will get the exact markings because already the lines are given to you. Now 9th. For 9th it is 90. So here 90. So here you will get another bar graph. And the last is for 10. For 10 number of children is 80. So 80 is over here. Now your bar graph is completed. Now here you can see that after looking to this bar graph you can find out that the highest number of children are in the 5th standard and the lowest number of children are in the 10th standard. So this way it becomes easy to find out the largest number of observation and smallest number of observations. Okay, we will move to the next. Question number 5. Consider this data collected from a survey of a colony. Now here a survey is done of a colony and here favorite sports are there: cricket, basketball, swimming, hockey and athletics. Now here number of people who are watching these sports and number of people who like to participate in these sports are given to you. Two observations are given to you. That means that in one single bar graph you are not be able to denote all these numbers. So what we will do, we have a double graph concept. We have to go for it. Now in single graph we were having a graph in this manner, that single graphs were there, single bars you can see we were having. Now for double graph, one graph will be attached with the another. In this manner we will have the double graphs. You can see two bar graphs are attached with each other with a one common line. Now let us see how to draw for this. First we have to take the scale. Now here we will write the number. So what this all numbers represent, that represent the number of people in the colony. So here we have to write down number of people in the colony. Now what we will write over here about the watching and participating, that means we are going to write all this cricket, basketball, swimming, hockey there on the bar. So that is their favorite sport. So here we have to denote it as a sport. Now here y-axis is we have to draw after that x-axis. Now how to take the scale? Here the lowest number is 105 and the highest is 1200 40. Now from 100 to 1200 if we will go, or 300 we will go, we will take a scale of 1 centimeter is equal to 100 people. Then we have to go from 100 till 1300. That means a long more space we will need over here. So to shorten up this, what we will take, 1 centimeter is equal to 1200 people we can take. So what, so here the scale we can take it as 1 centimeter is equal to 1200 people. Now here first it will be 0 over here, where the y axis and the x axis intersect, that point is 0. Now here it will be 200 gap we are taking. After 200 here it will be 400, 600, 800, 1000, 1200 and 1400. So we will cover all the numbers, means 105. So 105, where we will get, here we can get 105 between here 0 to 200. That means if we will halfen this, then here somewhere we will get 100. After that here up 105 is larger than 100. That means here 200 is there, here 0 is there. Here so at the between we will get 100. So here after this again one line is there, that we will consider it as 110. So here what we will get, 105 over here. So 105 also we can mark on this graph. So let us see now. First we will start from cricket for watching. It is 1240. So here 1240 will be between 1400 and 1200. Now here 1400 and 1200, that means at the middle we will get 1300. Now 1240. So after 1200 here 1210, 10, 20, 30 and 40, here somewhere we will get 1240. So here we will mark it as 1240. It is for cricket. Again this graph we will do for the watching. Now another graph, another bar, that is for participating. For the cricket only we are having 620, where we will get 620 in between 600 and 800. So between 600 and 800 here at the middle midpoint, what we will get, here 700, but we will need 620, means after 600 here 610, after that 620. So here we will get 620. So here we will draw this another bar attached with this. Here it is about watching, which is plain. Now here about participating we will shade it. So all the bars which are shaded, that will represent the participating. So here we have to write down that also, that for these bars it is, they represent the participating. All these things you have to write down over here, you will have space in your notebook. 1 centimeter is equal to 200 people. Plain bar graph represents the watching and the shaded one represents the participating. So both these bar are for cricket. Here you can see cricket, when for watching it is 1240 and for the cricket for participating it is 620. Now next, for basketball, for watching it is 470. Now 417 will be over here, between 600 and 400 we will get 500 at the middle. Now we want 470, that means that if we will minus 30 over here, means 3 step downwards, over here we will get 470. So here we are drawing the bar for watching. Now for basketball we have to draw for participating, that is 320. Now for 320, where we will get 320? Here you can see between 200 and 400 we can get 300. So at the middle it will be 300. After 300, 310, 320. Now after leaving one line and the second, we will get over here 320. So here 320. So it will be over here. We will draw the bar. Now this bar we have to shade it, because this is 320 is for participating. Now both this bar represent what? Basketball. So here we will write down basketball. Now next is swimming. Now for swimming, for watching it is 510. So where we will get 510? Here between 400 and 600, 500 is there. Now after 500, if we go one step over there, then 510 we will get over here. So this is for watching, we have drawn till 510 the bar. Now after that, for participating it is 320, means 320 same as this one of participating of basketball. So it will be equal to this bar graph only. So this represents 510 and 320 as swimming. So write down over here swimming. So now next is hockey. For hockey watching is 430. So 430 will be between 600 and 400. Middle point will be 500. We need 430, means after 400, 410, 420, 430, somewhere over here we are going to get. Now for hockey of participating, the number of participants are 250. So 250 we will get between 300 and 200. Here at the middle we will get 250. So here we can draw 250 and that we have to shade it, because this bar is for participating and the plain bar is for watching. Now for what we have drawn this? This we have drawn for hockey. So write down hockey at the top. Now after this, athletics. Now for athletics, for number of people for watching is 250. So here you can get 250 over here, same as this, but it will be in the plane because we are representing it for watching. After that 105. Now 105 we will get between 0 to 200, the middle point will be 100. Now 105 means after 100 we will get 1 point as 110. Between this 110 and 100, the middle point one, we will get over here somewhere. Now here will be 105. So here we will draw 105. That will be in the shaded form, as there this is for the participating. Now here it is for athletics. So this way double graphs are drawn. Whenever two observations parallel you are given to you, here watching and participating, number of people watching the sports and participating in the sports means two different types of observations are given to you. So whenever two different types of observations are given to you, you have to represent them in the form of double bar graph. Now from here what we can get, that the number of people watching and participating the cricket is the highest. And for lowest, which bar graph is lowest? Here you can see this bar graph is lowest. So the number of people who are watching and participating the athletes is is the minimum or the smallest. So here minimum people are watching the athletes, watching and participating, and maximum people are watching and participating the cricket. It is chance and probability. Now here some examples are given to you and some three categories are given to you. You have to sort out them in these three categories. Let us see the first example, the sun coming up from the west. Now here the sentence is given over there that the sun is coming from the west. Can sun come from west? No, it can never come from west. So this sentence is impossible. So first sentence can be categorized as impossible. Some things which can never be possible are called impossible. Now next is an ant growing to 3 meter height. Can an ant grow to 3 meter height? No, 3 meter height means 300 centimeter. That much large ant cannot be there. So this sentence is also impossible. Now next, if you take a cube of larger volume, its side will also be larger. Now if I am taking a cube, this is smaller and now this is larger. Now here you can see, if you take a cube of larger volume, if it is smaller then it is having smaller sides, and if the volume is greater then the cube sides will be greater. That means this is possible. Possible means it is certain that this can happen, and certain to happen and can happen but not certain means not specific that that thing will only do. But over here you can see that this can happen also means it is certain and happen means certain to happen. So third one can be categorized as certain to happen. The things which are possible are certain, and which are can happen are categorized as certain to happen. Now fourth one, if you take a circle with larger area then its radius will also be larger. Now if I am taking a circle of radius 2 cm, its area is this much. Now if I am increasing the radius 4 cm, you can see the area is also increased over here. That means that whenever if you are taking a circle with larger area you are taking, then the radius will also become larger, if and vice versa it can also happen. So this fourth one can be categorized as certain to happen. Now fifth one, India winning the next test series. Now this sentence you can see that India winning the next test series. Here two possibilities are there. It can win also and can lose also. So two possible things are there. It is not possible that whatever it is said that it will win only. Means this can happen. Means can happen but not certain. Specific that it will win, that is not possible. It may lose also. So the last sentence can be said as can happen but not certain. Now few more examples are there, that if you are tossing a die. Now if you are tossing a coin, then there are two possibilities that you will get head or tail. Other than this you are not going to get any other thing. Now let us move to the next. Here we will take one example that tossing a coin. Now whatever thing you are doing, that means tossing a coin, that thing is called a event. Now outcome. Now after tossing a coin, what you will get as a outcome means head and tail. Two possible outcomes are there. Whenever you are tossing a coin, then either you will get a head or either you will get a tail. Both together you are not going to get. Head and tail means whatever result you are getting after performing the event is called outcome. Now how to find the probability? Probability is equal to number of favorable outcomes divided by number of possible outcomes. Here we will do this by this example. Find probability of getting head on tossing a coin once. Now once you have to toss the coin and you have to find out the probability of getting head. That means when you are tossing a coin, how many possible outcomes are there? One is head. So possible outcomes are two. One is head and the another is tail. Means two possible outcomes are there. Now favorable, which is asked to you that for getting head, the result you should get will be head. That means it is possible once. So favorable outcome is equal to head. You want head as your result. So head, that means once only you will get the head. So how to find out the probability? Probability is equal to number of favorable outcomes. Favorable outcomes means only head you want, means one, divided by number of possible outcomes. Number of possible outcomes are possible outcomes. Whenever you are tossing a coin, then how many possible outcomes are there? Head and tail means two. Now if we are talking about the event, if we are taking event as a, find the probability of getting four. On die. Now here you can see on a die there are how many numbers are there? Here on the all the six sides there are 1, 2, 6 numbers denoted on the die. Now here find the probability of getting 4 on die, means number you want 4, means here favorable outcome is equal to 4 number can only come once, because another 4 is not on the die, so it will come only once. Now possible outcomes, how many possible outcomes are there? How many numbers are there on the die? 1, 2, 6 means 6 possible outcomes are there. If we are throwing a die once, then you may get any number between 1, 2, 6. But 7, 8, 9, that numbers you are not going to get. So the possible outcomes are 1, 2, 6 means how many? 6 possible outcomes are there. So we have to find out the probability. So probability is equal to number of favorable outcomes divided by number of possible outcomes. It will be equal to 1 divided by 6. 1 by 6 is less than 1, and the further example which we have seen for the tossing a coin, that probability was 1 by 2. That means that the whenever probability you are getting, probability will be between 0 and 1. Now when you will get the probability 0? Now if find the probability of getting 7 on a dice. Now when you will get 7, you will never get 7. So the for favorable outcomes, 7 you can never get. So the favorable outcomes, the number of favorable outcome becomes 0. And possible outcomes, whenever you are throwing a die, then 6 possible outcomes are there. From 1 to 6 numbers, you can get any number. But 7, it is not possible. That means for probability of getting 7 is 0 divided by 6, it will be 0. So, the probability, whatever probability you are getting, you will always get between 0 and 1. That's all about this chapter.